next on NCBA's Cattlemen to Cattlemen.
We're heading to the kitchen for a look at some of our favorite beef recipes. The chefs from the Culinary Innovation Center share beef cooking tips for any occasion.
And now, NCBA's Cattlemen to Cattlemen with host Kevin Oxner.
Hello and welcome to this week's special edition of NCBA's Cattlemen to Cattlemen. I'm Kevin Oxner. Thanks for joining us. We're coming to you from San Diego, California, the site of the 2016 Cattle Industry Convention and NCBA Trade Show. It's a gathering of several thousand cattlemen and women that will offer great speakers, valuable information, and outstanding cattle industry education. Plus, there'll be fun and entertainment for the whole family in sunny San Diego. And there'll be a special cattle industry party on the deck of the historic aircraft carrier, the USS Midway. That and much, much more all adds up to a cattle industry convention you don't want to miss. Registration and information is all online for you at the website beefusa.org. Rest assured, there'll be plenty of great beef on the menu in San Diego. And if you're looking for some great new ideas for preparing beef meals, then you're in luck. Today, we're looking back at some of the great tasting beef recipes prepared by the chefs at the Beef Culinary Center. Let's head into the kitchen. If you're like me, football season's always a time to enjoy family, friends, and food. Kristen Ledgerwood from the Culinary Innovations team is with us, and let's talk tailgating with beef, Kristen.
Of course. Well, I think a lot of people think of beef to take when they're tailgating, but I don't think a lot of people think of brisket as an option.
Burgers, normally.
Right. Yeah. Burgers are a go-to, so sure. Why not try something different and do a little brisket? This recipe today, we're doing a braised brisket.
Okay.
We're going to make some street tacos.
Okay.
But we're going to do everything besides building your tacos ahead of time.
Perfect.
So you can just take it with you.
Enjoy the game.
And enjoy the game.
Yeah, enjoy the friends. That's fantastic. And
yeah.
So you've already got a brisket started here, it looks like.
I did. So I went ahead, added a little bit of olive oil into my stock pot,
okay.
And I'm starting to brown the both sides of my brisket.
Okay, for somebody who likes to barbecue brisket, you're worrying me a little bit when you put the brisket in a stock pot and start browning it.
You're wondering
it.
About
so
it,
I'm,
aren't you?
I am. You're going to have to sell me on this concept. I love barbecue brisket.
Well, this is a braised recipe, so we're going to add some liquid to it,
okay.
And we're going to get it cook it until it's fork tender,
okay.
Which it's just going to melt in your mouth.
Very good.
So it's another alternative to what you're traditionally use
sure.
your brisket for.
Smoking or barbecuing, yeah.
Right. So like I said, we've just gotten this a little bit nice and brown. We're
okay.
going to brown both sides of those.
Sure.
And then we've got a little bit of that olive oil left in there.
Okay.
And we're going to start adding some of our aromatics to the recipe.
Give it a little extra flavor and so
That's
forth.
That's right.
What do we have in terms of aromatics?
We have some onions.
Okay, sure.
So we've sliced some onions.
About how
in
much?
There.
Just several?
Just about a half a cup of onions.
Okay, that's good.
And some minced garlic.
Perfect.
So this is all gonna mix in there and it's gonna get nice and flavorful. You're gonna start to smell it. A lot of times people wonder what you're cooking and
right.
it's those onions and garlic that
yeah.
really start to make the smell.
Smells, yeah, I love those two anyway.
Yeah.
I don't ever think of them with brisket, but so you're just going to kind of cook those for about how long then?
Just till they're sautéed enough to a little translucent. We're really just going to, about 4 or 5 minutes or
okay.
so,
all right.
Just to bring out that that lovely smell that you usually get with it.
Yeah, absolutely.
And then we're going to go ahead and add our brisket back in on top of our onions.
Okay. Very
so
good.
We'll do that.
And then you've got some other things here, and I'm not sure what you've brought us here.
Well, everybody, when they go tailgating, usually has some beer around,
okay,
right?
Okay, sure.
So you take one of those bottles of beer that you're going to...
That you were going to drink,
and we're going to go ahead and add it to our brisket.
Okay.
So we've just got one bottle of beer.
Just as kind of a tenderizer, or what else
this
is it
gonna
doing?
It's going to help yeah. break it down, but it's also going to be some flavor,
yeah.
a lot of flavor. Tomatillo salsa.
Okay.
So you can just find this in the grocery store, just a jar, and you're going to add some of that salsa in there.
Very good.
Now you can tell it's kind of quieted down a little
yeah.
bit.
Yeah, yeah.
So we're just going to stir that in there.
Okay. And how long are you going to cook all these things then?
This is going to go for about 2.5 to 3 hours.
Oh, wow.
But our key is looking for fork tenderness.
Okay.
So you're going to stick a fork in there, and you're looking for the brisket to actually pull away from the fork.
Very good.
And that's when you know it's at that nice tenderness
stage. And speaking of fork tender, did you bring a sample for us?
I did.
I saw that.
So we went ahead and cooked up brisket beforehand for
wow.
y'all. And so what you do after it gets to that fork tenderness stage, we're going to take the brisket out. We're going to go ahead and slice it.
Oh, yeah.
The sauce we're going to reduce down. We're going to make a little bit thicker, and we're going to add the brisket back into it.
One more time.
So,
and what does that do?
It's going to add a little bit extra moisture,
flavor.
And then your flavor is going to hold into your brisket. So.
And then you're going to take that in a crock pot or something to just keep it warm. Is that right?
Whatever you usually travel to that you can keep warm at while you're tailgating, just go ahead and put it in there, and then while you're making your tacos.
Yeah, tell us about the tacos themselves.
Sure, yeah, so you pick your favorite corn tortilla, flour tortilla, whatever you like at the store. Pick that up. We're going to add the brisket back in there, and then some of our great toppings, some salsa, cilantro, green onions, whatever you feel like.
Looks delicious, and it's especially easier. Just cuts down the stress and the hassle at the tailgating party itself. Kristen, you've taken tailgating to altogether different level this fall with beef. Thanks for bringing us this recipe.
Trying to make it easier, so thanks for having me, Kevin.
You bet. For this and other outstanding recipes, visit beefitswhatsfordinner.com, or you can go to our website at cattlemen2cattlemen.org. We'll be right back.
No storm is too powerful for new Purina wind and rain storm minerals, formulated with ultimate weather resistance. That means more minerals in the feeder and available to your cattle. Wind and rain storm minerals provide more consistent intake and balanced mineral nutrition to optimize herd health and breedback rates. See the difference at your local Purina dealer or visit cattlenutrition.com. Wind and rain storm minerals, another way Purina is building better cattle.
There are many great reasons to join NCBA, and that includes exclusive NCBA member-only discounts, such as savings on new equipment purchases from New Holland.
Hi, I'm Mike Corman with New Holland Agriculture, and I'm pleased here to talk about our New Holland member benefits to the National Cattlemen's and Beef Association members. New Holland offers special benefits to NCBA members, where they can save up to $1,000 off the purchase of a New Holland equipment. Members can save off the purchase of New Holland hay and forage and mid-range tractors, as well as other products. We have New Holland dealers located throughout the United States. Stop into your New Holland dealer and learn more. New Holland and NCBA, smart partners for agriculture.
Savings on equipment purchases from New Holland is just one of the fantastic deals you get as an NCBA member. Don't miss out. Join NCBA today at beefusa.org.
Hi everyone, Russell Nimitz here for NCBA's Cattlemen to Cattlemen. We have a beautiful Southern California coastline behind us, and that's because we're getting ready to set sail for San Diego for the 2016 Cattle Industry Convention and NCBA Trade Show. Lots of information plus lots of great entertainment. To get registered today, visit beefusa.org, and we'll see you here in San Diego.
We're back in the kitchen with Shanoa French from the Culinary Innovations team. And Shanoa, holidays are approaching, and you're bringing us a recipe, I understand, that uses beef in a wonderful new appetizer.
It is. It's actually our play on cranberries and holiday stuffing.
Sure.
So in an appetizer format, you can serve at any type of party you want. The great thing about this is we're going to actually talk about something that's kind of on trend right now is the custom grinds.
Oh.
So that's where we're going to start. A lot of people have their favorite cut of meat,
okay.
and they want to be able to use it in different ways. It's not something that you have a ribeye steak that you can only put on the grill. So what we're going to do is we've created a custom blend, a meat blend, and we're going to make just just traditional meatballs after we've done that.
Very good.
So our blend is, it's a little bit of brisket.
Okay.
A little bit of ground beef.
Yes.
And a little bit of ribeye. So a little bit of that extra fat flavor for you. And
all
I'm going to go
together.
Ahead, yeah, mix together. I'm going to throw gloves on just so we can work through this, but at home you don't need to.
Yeah, I have to admit I've not done any of my own custom grinds, but interesting concept.
Yeah, and so if you walk into the grocery store, into your meat counter, and you can tell them, you can ask for them to grind this for you.
Sure.
This recipe is kind of a small amount, so they might not want to do that for you, but you can do it at home in a food processor
or a
Cuisinart. Most people have these at home.
Sure.
So we're going to dump this meat in here. The most important thing with this is that to make sure that your pieces are all about the same size to start with.
Okay.
I know sometimes when you go into the grocery store, you can get a coarse grind or a chili grind or a fine grind.
Yes.
And making sure that your pieces are all about the same time or size to start with will kind of help make that process happen.
Yeah.
So last little guys are our ribeyes.
And about how much total are you using?
This is a pound.
A pound total.
So, yeah, and we're going to end up making 24 little meatballs.
Mm.
And so they are the appetizer, three or four to a piece. So, like I said, just stick them in there. The trick to this is going to be your pulse button.
Okay.
So make sure everything's locked in.
Mm-hmm.
You're just going to pulse it.
Oh, wow.
And it's going to slowly...
Got to wrestle to the ground, don't you?
Stick them on the counter, and you're going to pulse them until it goes to the grind that you want. And you notice it kind of has to grab them at a different size.
Yes.
But once you've got them all ground in there, you're just going to take your lid off. And you can kind of move them around if they're sitting on the blade where they need to. And you can see that they're kind of mixing. I'm going to do it one quick more little time. Make sure we really get this going in
That's amazing. I've never done that. Whoa.
Ooh.
We got locked up
Not sure what I did here.
It's all right. Hit a piece of bone or something.
There's no bone in there. Yeah. So
you always fillet the ribeyes before you put them in the Cuisinart. That's always good.
So we're going to show you how you mix the rest of these meatballs together from that. But if you continue to use the pulse button, it'll grow. And you can see there's tiny little pieces in here.
Right.
And that'll give you a different bite in the size of your meatball.
Really?
Yeah. So the more that you process it all the way down and it gets smoother in there, the bite will be much softer. And you leave them a little bit bigger, you'll have a more... a chew to your meatball.
Oh, interesting.
So that's the one thing to think about, yeah. So what we're going to do, and the nice thing about having a big bowl here is then we can just mix directly in this bowl.
Sure.
So standard meatball recipe, which is really simple, a little bit of garlic. So you're going to start with crushed garlic. If you don't want to use fresh, you can go ahead and use powder or granulated.
Okay.
That'll go in there.
Yes.
A little bit of pepper.
Pepper, absolutely.
That in there.
Good.
This calls for one egg. I went ahead and beat it before we put it in here, but you can add it. Again, we've talked about before is that you don't want to overmix sometimes.
Okay.
So if that's why I usually mix it up ahead of time.
Sure.
And then it's a little bit of water.
Oh.
You can't see that in there, but there's three tablespoons of water in there.
Okay.
And then what makes this some of our mini Mary is that you're going to take your standard stuffing mix.
Oh, really?
So a prepackaged stuffing mix. A lot of people use these around the holidays.
Sure.
Mix a couple different things into them. And that is going to be kind of your binder or your breadcrumbs that you would normally add into meatball mix.
Brings a separate flavor itself, too.
And it really brings that smell of the sage without having to add another bunch of ingredients. So then you would just basically take this, mix it in with your hands.
Yes.
And the thing is you're going to make 24. Most of the time when you're making meatballs, you make them a little bit bigger.
Yes.
But I like to say that these should be about the size of a large gumball.
Wow.
Little kid. So you need 24 out of a pound, which is bigger than normal. So you get all these and you put them on a baking sheet like normal, bake them in the oven for 16 to 20 minutes so they're nice and golden brown, 160 degrees internally. And then you're going to serve them over here.
Wow.
And as we talked about the holiday, bringing that theme in, the sauce that's in the middle there is it's a homemade cranberry barbecue sauce.
I wondered what was making it so red.
Yeah. So it's whole fresh cranberries.
Okay.
And you're adding a normal barbecue sauce ingredients. It's ketchup, molasses, brown sugar, a little bit of water, some onions, and you're going to put it on the stove in a stock pot and let it cook and simmer down for about 20 minutes. And then the trick to get that real nice shine to it and real smooth texture is you're going to run it through a blender. And the trick is that you want to use why it's still warm, so it'll process through a little bit easier.
Wow.
But you'll run it through a blender, and then you can serve the meatballs and cranberry barbecue sauce together.
What a unique way to utilize beef in an appetizer with a lot of the ingredients you're already going to have at holiday time.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for bringing this idea to us. For this and other outstanding recipes, visit beefitswhatsfordinner.com or you can go to our website at cattlemen2cattlemen.org. We'll be right back.
Got grain fever? Your John Deere dealer has the cure. Big savings on new tractors, hay tools, and more. Choose from cashback offers and low-rate financing options during grain fever. And to sweeten the deal, go online to greenfever.com/bonus to download your coupon for even bigger savings above and beyond the great deal. Get the gear you need and the savings you want at greenfever.com/bonus. Then go see your John Deere dealer for the cure.
Hello, Philip Ellis here to invite you to a great event, the NCBA Peck Party on the Pacific and Live Auction. It's happening right here in San Diego on Friday, January 29th, starting at 5 p.m. This event is always a great way to connect with friends and enjoy some outstanding music, food, and fun. Plus, you can participate in the live auction with the proceeds going directly to benefit our efforts in Washington, D.C. So join me at the Peck Party on the Pacific. See you there.
There are many great reasons to join NCBA, and that includes exclusive NCBA member discounts and benefits from some outstanding companies.
Hi, this is Kerry Bastine, president of Roper Apparel and Footwear, Stetson Apparel Boots, and Tin Hall. We are very proud sponsors of the NCBA, and for all new members signing up with the NCBA, you get 50% off your first purchase, and for all Go Forward members, you get 25% off. Four times a year, go to urbanwesternwear.com, click on the NCBA specials, use your coupon code for your first 50% off, and come back to Urban Western Wear all year long and use your 25% coupons that you'll find in the National Cattlemen's newspaper.
Big discounts on boots, clothing, and Western apparel is just one of the many amazing deals you get as an NCBA member. Don't miss out. Join NCBA today and enjoy these exclusive member discounts. Find out more at beefusa.org.
If you like pot stickers, then you know that Asian influences have had a big effect on food in America over the last couple of decades. And we have a great Asian influence recipe we're going to cook up for you today. As Kristen Ledgerwood from the Beef Culinary Team joins us. Now, I understand, Kristen, as you were mentioning before, this is actually using a beef sausage that you all developed there at the Beef Culinary Center. Is that right?
That's right. We've actually come up with about five or six different beef sausage recipes.
Wow.
And so this is one of our newer ones, mm-hmm. and it's utilizing some different Asian ingredients be able to make an Asian-style sausage.
Wow.
Now, with the other ones, we've got such flexibility. You can just a change of some ingredients, and you could have a Spanish-style, an Italian, a breakfast sausage, even a German sausage. So very versatile and a lot of fun.
So this is just using ground beef, mm-hmm. and then this mix of spices.
That's right. And so each recipe has its specific spices, but they're all that you would find in your pantry.
Super easy. Well, I hear something sizzling over there. Tell us about this recipe here. Very interesting.
Well, this is our Asian style beef pot stickers.
Uh-huh.
So this is a really great recipe for you to make when you're going to have a party.
Sure.
Have some guests over. Maybe you want to have a really nice dinner and add this to it. Or even bring in the family or the kids in to have some fun.
A little finger food. Yeah.
It is. Yeah. They have a lot of fun making it. It's very easy to do. So
very cool.
All we've done, really, like I said, we go back to that beef sausage recipe as we've added in some soy sauce, a little bit of honey,
mm-hmm.
Some mirin, and a couple different spices into our ground beef to make our Asian sausage.
Okay.
And then from there, I simply just added some shredded cabbage.
Oh, okay.
And to make things really quick and easy for me, I just picked up some from the grocery store that's already shredded.
Gotcha.
So we've mixed that all up together.
Yep.
And then I went and picked up some wonton wrappers.
And I have to ask you, where do you find these?
These can actually, most are going to be located in the produce section of your local grocery store.
Very interesting.
Close to, usually by the herbs, the fresh herbs is usually
very
where
good.
They are. So they're just nice square little pieces here.
Wow.
And very versatile.
Very
so we're
thin,
just very
they?
Thin.
Mm-hmm.
And they dry out very fast.
Okay.
So as you can notice, I have some paper towel here that's a little damp.
Yeah.
That's to help keep the moisture in there and from them getting crispy around the edge before we cook them. So I'm going to also use my teaspoon today because I don't want to overstuff my pot stickers. Otherwise, they'll start to overflow.
Burst.
And burst.
I can imagine, make a mess out of the pan.
That's right. So this is as simple as it is. Take a teaspoon of your filling.
Yeah. So a combination of the sausage as well as the cabbage.
That's
You're
right.
just kind of putting a little bit
You're
of both
put in there.
Yep.
And then I am going to take my finger and I'm just going to wet the edges with a little bit of water that I have setting here.
All right.
And then this is the hard part.
Okay.
You're going to fold it over.
Oh, wow. Okay. Fold it over and
fold it over.
Stick it together?
And stick it together. The big
Simple.
Thing is you want to try to get all that air out. So I just kind of move around what I have.
Push it out to the sides,
yep.
huh?
And out like that.
I'll be darned.
And seal it. And just like that, as you can
Simple.
See, we started.
Yeah.
That's your pot sticker.
And then what do you do to cook them then?
So to cook them, I have a hot skillet with a little bit of Pam spray in there. That's going to help keep them from sticking, the nonstick, but then also crisp them up a bit.
Okay.
And we're going to start off just heating them up. And once they've cooked about 3 minutes or so, mm-hmm. we're going to actually add a little bit of water and lit it.
Very good.
And the whole purpose of this, and you want to do this a little careful, get that going. And you're going to lid this. It's going to start to actually steam the pot stickers.
Oh, and so you want them to see. Oh, wow,
yeah.
look at that. Interesting.
Yeah.
And then this is our final
finished product.
I assume you have, what, some soy sauce and sweet and sour sauce, or what do you have there?
Yeah, we've got a soy sauce, and then that is a sweet chili sauce.
Sweet chili.
So if you like it, just a little,
spicy.
Have a little heat spice to it. You can choose your own condiment with it.
What a great idea for appetizers, or like you say, just to make a meal a little bit more special, have fun with the kids. We've never fixed these in our household. It'll be a lot of fun.
Thanks for coming. Thank you for having me.
To make your own beef sausage pot stickers and to find other great recipes, visit the website beefitswhatsfordinner.com. Or you can always see recipe video replays on our website. That's cattlemen2cattlemen.org. It's a fast-paced world for everyone these days, especially for families. And making meals fast is sometimes a requirement. Christopher Geigel is with us today from the Beef Culinary Center, and he's going to tell us a little bit about a quick stir-fry recipe that works perfectly for busy families like ours. Is that right, Chris?
That's right. We have a sweet and sour beef stir-fry that was a State Beef Council-inspired recipe.
Outstanding.
So it's a pretty simple recipe, really straightforward. The first thing we're going to do is make a little sauce.
Yep.
So I have some sweet chili sauce here.
Okay.
Going to add that to this bowl.
Yeah. A couple of tablespoons or so, huh?
About a quarter cup.
Quarter cup. Yeah.
Add a little soy sauce to that.
Yeah. Perfect.
And a little bit of rice wine vinegar.
Oh, wow. That does it.
And that does it. We're just going to stir that up a little bit.
Okay.
We're going to let that sit there for a minute.
Right.
We have our vegetables here. We have some thinly sliced red bell pepper.
Okay.
And then also some snow peas that I sliced thinly as well.
I was wondering what those were.
Yeah, so I sliced them nice and thin because they cook really quickly that way. You can leave them whole. They're just going to take a little bit longer.
I love snow peas.
So I'm going to add those to this bowl here.
Yeah.
That and then the snow peas.
You bet.
And we're going to add a little bit of our sauce to that.
Oh, okay. And even before you cook it.
Even before we cook it, we're going to let them marinate a little bit.
Oh, okay.
Just like a tablespoon or two.
Yeah.
We're going to take the same fork here and just mix those up and let them sit there. While those are marinating, we have the top sirloin, which is the beef we'll be using in this recipe.
Gotcha.
It's a lean cut, so really good for those who are looking to watch their
weight. You bet, yeah.
Watch their weight.
Sure.
So we want the nice thin strips and small pieces for this, so we're going to take our knife and cut this lengthwise.
Okay, sure.
Like this, kind of leave them together there.
All right.
And then get some nice thin strips here.
I see. So they'll cook quickly, I suppose.
Yep, so they'll cook really quickly. So just a few really thin strips there.
Gotcha.
I did some of this earlier, so I'm going to add this beef to that.
Okay, that's perfect.
So before we add it to the frying pan, we're going to take this beef and add it to this bowl.
Okay. And in total, you know, if you're cooking for a family of five, about how much beef would I want, you suppose?
A pound to a pound and a half.
Yep.
To the beef, we're going to add some cornstarch.
Okay.
And some ginger.
Oh, is that what that is?
Yep. Right. So either finely minced ginger, or if you want to save some time in the fresh herb section in a grocery store, you can find some ginger paste already done for you.
Perfect.
And add that to that.
Gotcha. And then is this just going to make our browning or breading, or what is this
doing
here?
So this does a few things. One of them is for flavor. Okay. Ginger and onions and garlic are all kind of in this aromatic family, It adds a lot of flavor. The cornstarch adds to the browning and the flavor development, and also helps to keep the beef nice and tender.
Excellent.
So we're just going to mix that up and get it all coated real nice.
Interesting.
And then we have a frying pan over here, which I started heating already, so it'd be nice and hot for us.
Sure.
I'm just going to add a little bit of vegetable oil to that.
All right.
Just a tablespoon or so.
Right. Because this, again, is very lean.
Very lean. So just enough so it doesn't stick and to add some browning. So we're going to take part of this meat and add it to our frying pan here. Okay. It's really important when you're doing stir fry to do small batches.
Oh, really?
You can see here that I'm not covering the entire bottom of the frying pan, but I really want to spread out the meat here. That helps to brown it. If you add too much of it at one time, you wind up steaming the beef and you wind up with this gray beef and not the nice brown color and flavor that develops.
Okay. So you're going to just do this in like several batches?
Several batches. So you'd brown this, and then once it's brown on kind of both sides there, you can see it doesn't take but a minute to get nice and brown.
Exactly.
You would then take that out and add your next batch to it onto.
I see.
And then once it's all brown, you can kind of add it all back to the pan.
I see.
So this is pretty much there.
That's outstanding. And then you're going to, do you add the rest of your sauce too, or?
Yep, so at this point, with the rest of the beef, you would add your sauce.
Yep. Very good.
And your vegetables to that?
Look at that. That's smelling and sounding great.
And then you could just serve that over ramen noodles, or if you're doing the gluten-free thing or don't like noodles, you can always serve it over rice. They have those already cooked basmati and different rices in the stores.
Outstanding, and this is our finished product. Looks absolutely delicious, and that's smelling great, by the way.
Well, thanks.
Thanks so much for bringing this recipe.
Thanks for having us.
You bet. For this and other great beef recipes, visit the website beefitswhatsfordinner.com, or you can check them out and see video replays on our website. That's cattlemen2cattlemen.org. Don't go away. We'll have more of this special edition of NCBA's Cattlemen to Cattlemen right after this.
I have never wanted to do anything other than be in the cattle business. We use Triangle on the cows because it's been safe and effective and it's done us a good job. We're asking these cows to do more, so that has been a change. We have had just phenomenal results. We have very, very little loss. 100% of our cattle get vaccinated with Triangle.
New Holland is the undisputed leader in hay tools. We give farmers a wide range of innovative equipment that increases efficiency and productivity all year round. Because to us, smart means providing a smooth, clean cut with faster dry down, plug-free conditioning, and superior bale density. And smart means leaving less hay on the field to feed more livestock in less time. That's New Holland Smart. Visit your local New Holland dealer today.
Have you seen this one? It's the Big Bud 747. And now you can hear the story of this amazing machine from its owners in Montana and from the man who built this awesome tractor all those years ago. Order your very own copy of the DVD, Awesome, the story of the biggest tractor ever built. It's chock full of facts about this powerful tractor that featured a 16-cylinder diesel engine that generated 900 horsepower and could work an acre a minute. Order the DVD, Awesome, by calling 1-800-888-8979. Or you can shop online anytime at the website classictractors.com.
Welcome back. And joining us now is Shanoa French from the Beef Innovations Group to tell us more about convenient, fresh beef products. Shanoa, Steve Wald was just on the show talking about a new product for today's time-starved consumers. Tell us more about convenient, fresh beef products.
Well, like Steve mentioned, we have about 15 products that are available. Some of these are 3-in-1, so they can make more than one sandwich for them. But we brought the 3-in-1 kits here to show you. We're going to work through one of the recipes today, but just show you how great some of the other options are.
Sure.
So this first one is a sandwich kit. And what the great thing about this is you can do sandwich for lunch, you can do sandwich for dinner. And if you turn these packages over, it tells you as you pick them up out of the fresh meat case exactly what you would need to make each type of sandwich.
Neat.
So some of the consumers say, well, I buy these knowing that I have barbecue sauce at home, or I always always have onions at home, or I know that I don't have sour cream, so when I pick this up, I'll need to pick that up along with it. So, like I said, this is a sandwich kit, which is a great option.
Yeah.
This is the fajita kit, which a lot of consumers do fajitas at home. A lot of people are comfortable with that. Mm-hmm. There's frozen ones in the freezer right now, but this gives them a fresh option if they want to add some other lime juices and still make the seasoning how they like it. Add mushrooms, peppers, onions, bell peppers, no bell peppers, corn tortillas, flour tortillas, and then kind of garnish any way they want.
Yeah, so, fresh beef is always a better option,
absolutely.
It seems like to me.
Yeah,
that's
well,
great.
And it's quick, too, yeah. Which is great. The last one that I'm going to talk about, and this is the one I'm actually going to show you in demo, is more of the hearty one. So this one either does beef stroganoff, a beef and pepper, or a stew. So kind of depending on what you want to do. I went ahead, pulled the ingredients that we're going to need. Uh-huh. So I've got those here, and we're going to start using this kit. We'll show you how quick they
are. And we're going to do stroganoff today.
We are. So
let's get started.
I'm going to pull the sleeve off, okay. Which is real easy, and I'm going to turn it over because that's where your instructions are.
Outstanding.
So we'll start that. I'm going to turn this up so we have a little bit of heat going.
Okay.
This is really pretty quick. Peel the oval wrap mm-hmm. that you would have at the store, mm-hmm. just like you would at home, and this seasoning packet is right inside on top.
How convenient is that?
So I'm going to do this, slice it open.
Okay. Be careful with the knife there.
It's a little one, we're all okay. right? So this is going to be my mixing bowl.
All right.
Pretty quick. This is called the brown gravy package that'll come with your meat.
Very
it's
good.
A pound and a quarter.
All right.
About that. So it'll serve, and you can spread it out by adding different vegetables, and it'll kind of serve four or five or six, depending on how big your consumers
That's
are, how big your family is.
Super flexible.
A cup and a half of water.
Everybody has that.
Everybody has water. So.
That's great.
And then the only other tricky thing is going to be sour cream.
Oh, wow.
Quarter a cup of sour cream.
Wow.
You want to use plain yogurt, whatever you like to use at home. And this all just gets mixed in here.
That's outstanding. I know we've always talked about trying to limit the number of ingredients just to make beef more convenient
yeah,
for consumers.
This one is
that's really convenient.
Is very simple. I'm going to use a whisk, and okay. you want to get rid of the lump that's
okay.
in there
sure.
and kind of incorporate your sour cream.
Wow.
So we're going to mix that up. This will cook, and this is also actually what's the thickening agent to kind of make that stroganoff. So
it's the easiest gravy I've ever seen.
There you go, right? Uh-huh. So I'm going to push this to the side, and we're actually going to start with our meat.
Okay.
Pan is, you know, medium-high heat. You don't sure. want it too hot. And as we start adding things into this pan, mm-hmm. they'll cook long enough to make sure your meat comes to temperature. So
gotcha.
This first step is just a searing. You're going to brown it just about a minute.
Okay.
We don't want to cook too long because then your meat's going to be overdone at the end process.
And what kind of oil are you putting
just
in?
Just a touch of olive oil.
Olive oil, perfect.
Kind of to make sure things don't stick in there.
Good.
I'm going to spin this around a little bit.
That's great.
We've got some heat going on our pan. I'm going to use some tongs. As I put the meat in here, mm-hmm. you're going to want to make sure that it's kind of separated so
okay.
that we don't have clumps.
Sure.
So that's why I'm going to use these tongs. You can use your hands at home.
Sure.
You'll hear that sizzle. You want
Love
that.
It.
We're looking to brown.
Yeah.
As we've talked about before, some of the Maillard reaction that happens.
Yeah.
That browning adds flavor. So I'm going to kind of dump all these in here. And this only calls the instructions, as you'll see, say just brown it for about a minute.
Okay. Real quickly.
Yeah. So we just want to get that sear on that.
You bet.
So, as we work through that.
Now, you used a separate set of tongs.
Yeah.
Just for food safety.
For food safety,
That's
yep.
That's great.
Like I said, if I was at home, I would have used my fingers
sure.
for that part. But here, so you can see we've got some brown on those pieces.
Okay.
And what we're going to do now is I'm going to flip them all over.
Right.
Keep them kind of separated.
Yeah.
And I'm going to add our mushrooms.
Right.
So this is 8 ounces of sliced mushrooms.
Okay.
The recipe also or calls for canned mushrooms.
Ah.
If you like canned mushrooms better, make sure you drain them.
Yeah.
We're going to toss these in here.
All right.
And we're just letting them all kind of
wow.
cook together.
Perfect.
You're looking for some of that sear, the heat on them.
Yeah.
Don't put a lid on here. Mushrooms have some water in them.
Okay.
Otherwise, you'll end up with a steamy mess.
Oh, okay. Gotcha.
So kind of keep this working.
Yep.
Yeah. Throwing mushrooms.
A rogue mushroom.
Jumping. So you want to stir fry this long enough that your beef, as you can see in this one, has some of that caramelization.
Yes.
That doneness to it.
Right.
But you don't have to cook this for like 5 minutes to make sure everything is done. Because what we're going to do is we're going to add this liquid here.
Yes.
And whisk that in. And then
it'll continue cooking.
It'll continue to
cook. Oh, perfect.
This will thicken, and that gives you what some of your gravy is.
Gotcha.
So I had the heat turned down a little bit. So we're getting a little tiny steaming. You can see that in
yep.
the pan. But that's
sure
why it's important to keep that medium heat up on
yep.
your stove.
It's okay to have some liquid in there, though, right now.
It's okay a little bit, yeah. If I had my heat up a little bit, well, you wouldn't see that.
Gotcha.
So that's one of those things that we'll kind of keep
very
remembering,
good.
But some of these pieces are still raw, so I'm going to give them just a couple more minutes. But what we'll do then is I'm going to take and whisk all of this in.
Okay.
Kind of make sure there's no lumps in there.
Wow.
And then this will become
super, super simple. That's amazing.
Yeah. So we're going to pour this over the top. Kind of mix it in there. Gotcha. Got a little lump on the side, so we'll add that. And wait for our pan to recover.
And then how long are we going to want to cook this?
This says that it simmers for about 3 minutes.
Wow.
So obviously we just poured cold water
and
some sour cream in there. Your pan's going to return. Mm-hmm. You'll start seeing a little bit. It's starting to boil. So you'll let this, you know, bubble for about 3 to 5 minutes.
Okay.
Make sure that it'll thicken.
Sure.
And then you can go ahead and serve it over the top of your favorite.
Outstanding.
Yeah, we used whole wheat noodles here. You can use rice. You can use spaghetti noodles. Whatever your family prefers to eat stroganoff over.
What a quick and convenient but delicious way to enjoy beef. Thanks so much for bringing us this recipe and this new product innovation.
Yeah, I'm hoping to have it in all the stores here soon.
That's exciting. For more information on convenient fresh beef, visit the Beef Innovations Group website at beefinnovationsgroup.com. Or you can visit our website at cattlemen2cattlemen.org. Still to come, we'll visit with Baxter Black. And we'll be back with more of NCBA's Cattlemen to Cattlemen after this short break.
Your herd, your business, your family. You've always protected what matters most, so you know how important vaccinations are for healthy cattle. And with Vista vaccines from Merck Animal Health, you know you're covered. No other vaccine works like Vista. Only Vista gives you complete dual-action pneumonia protection and complete one-dose fetal protection for the entire pregnancy. Protect what matters most. Talk to your veterinarian or animal health supplier about Vista.
There are many great reasons to join NCBA, and that includes exclusive NCBA member-only discounts from Cabela's.
We have an exclusive membership program that allows members of NCBA to buy our Cabela's co-branded gift cards at a 15% discount.
Use gift cards towards Cabela's purchases either online, through the catalog, or in-store. NCBA members can also purchase logo apparel from Cabela's at a discount.
And we do all of the NCBA's merchandise through the website. In that program, you can receive up to a 30% discount through the NCBA site. We have state association logos, all the Beef USA logos. We can use those to outfit your guys working on the ranch. Cabela's is proud to be a sponsor of NCBA and all their member base.
15% off gift cards to Cabela's plus savings on apparel is just one of the great deals you get as an NCBA member. Join today at beefusa.org.
We're back in the kitchen with Laura Majors, one of the recipe testers from the Beef Culinary Center. And Laura, I see you brought the slow cooker with you today. You know, we use a slow cooker a lot in our household. Why do you think it's become such a popular way to fix beef?
Yeah, Kevin, it's a popular way because you can take some of the larger cuts from the shoulder, from the rump, from the round, and you can cook it all day and come home and at least part of the dinner's already made.
You bet.
And then the reason we call it four-way is that you can take that beef, shred it, and then add different sauces or different ingredients to finish it off with to a lot of different flavors from different cultures, and we're going to show you four different ways to prepare it quickly.
Well, that sounds very exciting. Let's get started.
Okay, the first thing we want to do is make sure that the beef is done.
Okay.
We use what we call fork tender.
Uh-huh.
You're going to pull the pieces out of the slow cooker,
yep,
and you put it on like this, but I want you to see how easy this fork goes in, and that's fork done.
Very good.
And then to shred it, you can just take a couple of table forks and pull it apart, and you can see how easy that pulls apart.
Sure.
And you'll want to do that to the whole roast.
Okay.
And then you can make several dinners with this, or one, depending on how many people you have to feed.
Okay. And so now you've already got some shredded roast beef, it looks like.
Yeah, we have a little bit shredded here. We're going to show you the Indian, East Indian way that we would do this. We're going to add just a little tikka masala sauce.
Okay.
Stir it up
mm-hmm.
in there. And then this is what it's going to look like, just sauce. And depending on your finish, that's you're going to use either salsa or tikka masala, or for a Mexican dish you could use any of your salsas or Mexican sauces. Barbecue sauce also works. And then you'd want to cover this up, put it in the microwave for a minute, to heat everything up. You might have to stir it once, put it back in, and then your meat is all heated.
And for those people who want to go around the world while staying in the comfort of their own home, you've got several different alternatives
right,
for us.
Right, we do, and this is great to show kids how to cook. So they're going to get a lot of different ideas about what they can eat from different cultures. Mm-hmm. And with this one piece of beef, you can do several. Have a party and roll out a whole bunch of different sauces from different countries and ingredients.
Well, tell us about these.
Okay, thanks. This is an Asian piece. It's got some hoisin sauce. You can also use teriyaki, mix that in. It also has some cucumbers, a few peanuts, and some carrots.
Okay.
Then moving on to the barbecue sauce. It's a barbecue sandwich, whole grain bun, very healthy for your family.
What's in the pita?
The pita, and you can also use naan bread, would be the East Indian preparation that we prepared.
Okay.
And add some yogurt, some pistachio nuts, some of your other vegetables.
Interesting. And then finally, we've got, it looks like a kind of a Mexican burrito.
Yeah, it could be a taco, it could be a burrito. Shredded beef is really good with Mexican food. Add some avocados, some tomatoes, some onions, and there you have it.
So folks that want to do multiple alternatives for the same meal or just not eat leftovers over and over and create some variety in leftovers, this is a great option.
Yeah, it is. It really is.
Thank you so much, Laura.
Thank you, Kevin.
For this and other outstanding beef recipes, visit the website beefitswhatsfordinner.com or you can always find them on our website at cattlementocattlemen.org. We're back in the kitchen with Kristen Ledgerwood from the Culinary Innovations team. Now, Kristen, we know that beef is what's for dinner, but you've brought us a delicious recipe that we can start the day with. Is that right?
I have, actually. We think, you know, beef should be part of every meal, so why not include it in breakfast?
I agree.
So we've brought today, we've got a breakfast beef sausage and egg muffin cup recipe that we're going to share with you guys today.
Well, tell us how we do that. It looks like we've got, what, some ground beef or sausage, or what do you have here?
This is some lean ground beef.
Okay.
Very easy to put together. So you could actually put this together very quickly for your family, or if you're going to have a brunch. This is a really great way to be able to serve a beef meal as well very quickly. So, so like I said, lean ground beef is what we're going to start off with.
Sure.
And to make our breakfast sausage, we've got a few spices.
Okay.
So we have some rub sage.
Okay.
Okay. We have garlic powder.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
It's always good to
add a little flavor. We have onion powder.
Yes.
Some kosher salt.
Sure. Yep.
And a little heat. We've got some crushed red pepper in here.
Or a lot of heat. That's
depending on what you like.
I like
If you like a lot of heat, then you could probably double
that's
it, I'm
great.
Sure.
So,
and like I said, very easy. We're just going to go ahead and mix this all together until it's nice and combined.
Yeah, it's amazing because I've never thought of making sausage on the spot, right? I mean, we make our own German sausage and things like that, but this is great.
And a lot of people don't think of beef as an option for sausage.
Right.
So this is a really great way to do that. So, so we're just going to, like I said, just mix this up nice and thoroughly.
Okay.
We're going to put it in a skillet, a warm skillet, on the stove. We're going to cook it to 165 until it's nice and well done.
Okay.
And then we're going to add some green chilies and some shredded cheese.
More heat. So it looks like you've already done that.
We did. So we mixed that together in with the drained ground beef.
Okay.
And then we just portioned it out within a 12 muffin tin.
Okay.
Very quick and easy. And then the last and very complicated part is to mix
eggs. Is this similar to scrambled eggs?
This is very similar to scrambled eggs.
We can do this.
So I've got five whole eggs in here.
Okay.
And
with or without the shells?
Without shells.
Well,
I
now that's
the
difference
crunchy.
Between yours and my eggs.
That's right. I've got a quarter cup of some milk.
Okay.
So we're just going to add that in there.
Okay. That's good.
And again, a little bit of some heat. So depending on what you like and what you have in your kitchen for some hot sauce, we're going to add a little bit of some hot sauce in
there. Very good. And then you're just going to whip all that together, huh?
We are. We're going to just whisk this up.
I always wondered if you whip eggs or whisk eggs, but you probably whisk eggs. It's probably
I usually whisk them. But you can, you know, whatever you like to do in your own house,
don't be
you just
mean
let me
to,
know.
For,
so.
To chickens. All right. So then, and there's five eggs, and that's enough for a 12.
That is.
10.
So we're just going to pour that in there. You made a little bit of a mess, but
sorry.
That's all right. It's never a dull moment, right?
That's right.
So we'll just go ahead and, like I said, just portion this off into our tins.
How easy is that?
Very easy. And it's from here, it gets even easier. We're going to pop it in a hot oven at 375.
Okay.
And we're going to bake it for about 17 to 20 minutes.
All right.
What we're looking for is a little bit of golden brown, but the big key is to make sure that there isn't any runny eggs.
Sure.
So we will just finish those off there.
Outstanding. And we have, again, you said about 17 to 20 minutes to fully cook them.
Yep.
Outstanding.
So we went ahead and got some nice and hot for you.
Look at that.
So we'll pull those out, and you can see.
Look at that. Nice
that
and brown.
These are nice and golden brown.
That
and that they
delicious.
Are not runny at all, so.
Well, and this is our final effort here. Serve them with a little salsa and, I suppose, fruit or whatever else you want to serve
whatever
them with.
Whatever you'd like, depending on what your morning feels like.
Well, this is a great way to enjoy beef at the beginning of your day for breakfast. Thank you so much for coming to the show.
You're very welcome. Thank you for having me.
For this and other outstanding recipes, visit beefitswhatsfordinner.com or our website at cattlemen2cattlemen.org.
We'll be right back.
Hey, Russell Nimitz here for NCBA's Cattlemen to Cattlemen. We're here on a beautiful California coastline as we get ready to set sail for San Diego and the 2016 Cattle Industry Convention and NCBA Trade Show, packed full of fun and entertainment. Entertainment like country music star Martina McBride. Find out more by visiting beefusa.org.
Every truck can tow a boat. Every truck can climb a hill. Every truck can haul a trailer. But not everyone can say they're the fastest growing truck brand in America. Guts, glory, Ram.
Let's face it. You don't think a lot about your trailer hitch. You use it and forget it. We understand. But at B&W, we think about it. Short nights, long hauls, never-ending chores. The unthinkable. We think about it all, so you don't have to. B&W. Trusted.
Old Bill used to tell me, I've seen a lot of changes in my life, and I've been against every one of them. Well, Bill would have been against verification programs for sure. He would have ignored specialty markets like non-hormone, natural, and BQA. Too much trouble, he'd say. Bill's still driving his 76 three-quarter ton and still doesn't have a cell phone. If you're interested, visit imiglobal.com, or I could put you in touch with old Bill.
Ho, ho, ho. All my clothes are laundry. All my socks are full of holes. I've got TP in my hat band and cardboard in my soles. I've stuffed the want-ad section underneath my long john shirt. And my jacket's held together by dehorning blood and dirt. And the leather on my bridle's been fixed so many times, my horse looks like that fence post where we hang the baler twine. When I bought that horse, he was as good as most around. But when I sold him last month, he brought 13 cents a pound. I've been unable lately to invest in purebred cows since my ex-wives and their lawyers are dependents of mine now. See, my first wife took my saddle. And the second skinned my hide, and the third one got my deer head, and the last one took my pride. I've had a run of bad luck, but I think it's gonna peak, 'cause my dog that used to bite me got run over just last week. So all I want for Christmas is whatever you can leave, but I'd settle for a new wife who would stay through New Year's Eve.
It's Christmas time when we celebrate the birth of Christ.
More than 80% of Americans believe in God, and that's more people than have lawyers or drive foreign cars or pay income tax. Well, how can such a high percentage of our modern civilized population believe in an omnipotent being? Well, our entire concept of God exists by faith. It's not complicated. When I'm asked if I really believe Christ was born of a virgin, I say, of course. If I can believe in something as outrageous and unbelievable as God, I can surely believe Jesus was his son. And for the vast majority of us who do believe, Christmas is the recognition of something bigger than ourselves. It reminds us that Jesus was born to save the world, and he has. Merry Christmas, and God bless you from out there.
There are many great reasons to join NCBA, and that includes exclusive NCBA member-only discounts, such as savings up to $2,500 on new equipment purchases from John Deere.
We at John Deere are proud to be sponsors of the NCBA. We've been long-term sponsors and have been in the livestock business for over 125 years. John Deere has a wide variety of products that support you in the industry. We have a wide variety of discounts that are exclusive to you as NCBA members. You can visit our John Deere dealers locally throughout the United States to be able to find those specific discounts and the products that would apply to your needs. So thank you for being an NCBA member and allowing us to support you.
Saving big money on equipment purchases from John Deere is just one of the great deals you get as an NCBA member. Don't miss out. Join NCBA today at beefusa.org.
Set sail for San Diego and the 2016 Cattle Industry Convention and NCBA Trade Show. It's the cattle industry's biggest convention with education, networking, and fun that can't be beat. Plus, you can check out the huge NCBA Trade Show, and there will be a special event held on the historic USS Midway. It's the 2016 Cattle Industry Convention and NCBA Trade Show, January 27th through 29th in San Diego. Visit beefusa.org for more.
Now remember, the 2016 Cattle Industry Convention and NCBA Trade Show is coming up in San Diego, January 27th through the 29th. If you're in the beef business, it's an event you won't want to miss. Find out all you need to know by going to the website beefusa.org. Well, that wraps up this special edition of NCBA's Cattlemen to Cattlemen. Thanks so much for joining us. I'm Kevin Ochsner, and we'll see you next week right here on RFD TV.